Hello and welcome to a special feature of the overseas release, the Rotogrip Halo Burn. The Burn was released in 2018 and was one of my first overseas balls. It's pink, and because we all know what that means, I had to have one. I was a big fan of my original Halo and the Halo Pearl, and while the Burn is also a Pearl, it's the actual Pearl version of the Halo because they both share the Microtrax coverstock formula, while the Halo Pearl was the much weaker E-Trax formula. For a current comparison, the new Exotic Gem uses the Microtrax Pearl cover, while balls like the RSTX2 and Rubicon UC2 use the E-Trax Pearl cover, E-Trax Plus for the X2, but virtually the same strength range. The Exotic is one of the, if not the strongest, Pearl balls ever released, and the Burn is close on its heels. The Centrum Core in the Halo at a 249 RG, 050 differential, and an 018 intermediate differential is a bit weaker than the Defiant LRG core in the Exotic, so the Burn is longer and sharper, but still very close in strength. I'm on the Kegel Chromium lane condition. It's a challenge pattern at just under a 7-to-1 ratio, 42 feet, 25.5 mils, not as easy as a house shot, but not as difficult as a sport pattern, so it keeps you honest, but isn't too punishing. I featured the Burn in a handful of videos over the years, and while I've procured a backup, this is actually my righty Burn that I plugged and redrilled. Not a huge fan of plug bowling balls, but I had to take this one with me when I switched, and when done correctly with Storm Thunder plug, which is easily the best on the market, not even being a homer, anyone else will tell you the same, there's nothing to worry about from a plug perspective. The Burn shapes exactly like the Halo Pearl. The overall reactions are exceptionally similar. The Burn is just an easy arrow stronger, and I have a fun comparison here in a minute to show you the difference. I've always been a fan of stronger shiny covers because they handle volume and friction differently than the weaker and more responsive covers. While the Halo and Halo Pearl were great complements, the difference in cover formulas created a pretty big gap between the two. Sometimes when the Halo would start getting too strong, too early, or burning up, the lanes still weren't quite ready for the Halo Pearl yet. Now to be fair, up until just here in the last couple years, people weren't ready for or accepting of quote-unquote pearls that weren't skid-snap like an Astrophysics or a Halo Pearl. Stronger pearl covers like this, however, bridge the gap between strength and shape. They may not be as sharp as cleaner covers, but obviously the Burn has no issues making the corner, plus they get that shape while blending the lane better. Sometimes they can be a little hard to understand, admittedly, but that's just because of the pearl hybrid solid nonsense that people for some reason continue to push. To illustrate this, here's another pearl, but this one has the Halo Pearl coverstock, E-Trax, and actually the exact same version in E-Trax P18. The Torchit is also asymmetric, and virtually the only difference in the core is that the differential is a couple points higher. Even though the Torchit is still a great look, you can see that despite both balls being pearl, the Torchit is much easier down the lane and hooks less overall. It's obviously not weak by any means, but the difference is pretty apparent. Now, because I've still got a Torchit review coming, I'm not going to say too much more, it was just the perfect comparison. The overseas market is different. They get a lot more releases than we do, but in a lot smaller batches. While you can't get them in pro shops, you can find some on Bowler's Mart. Follow my link in the description, or you can check out SRGBBFS on Facebook if you find one that you're interested in. Remember to use my code ROSEDOLL10 at checkout at coolwick.com. Check out my YouTube memberships. Thanks to my outstanding members. Thank you for watching, and may the strikes be with you.